Mr. Speaker, okay, Jeff, I represent the good people of Buruku. My dear colleagues, I'm from Benue State. Mr. Speaker, I've consistently in the media and elsewhere stated my position on this matter. In this debate, however, I'll walk slightly back and try to play the devil's advocate as far as the issue. In doing that, I'll be more looking at ways of ending this crisis rather than apportioning blames. I've done trading blames in the past. How do we move forward? At the risk of sounding repetitive, let me once again cite Section 14, Subsection 2B of the 1999 Constitution that says that the security and welfare of the people is the primary purpose of government. So if, as Mr. Speaker has highlighted in his welcome speech, mentioned several motions, more than six motions that we have had in the past that seem to tackle this problem. And yet, here we are today trying to take a look at the same problem. It means that we have failed. Because if you cannot provide security of our people, we have failed. And when I say we have failed, I'm not just talking about the president, even though he's the head of the government. I'm talking about the House, the National Assembly, the House of Representatives. I want to look strictly at the issue of security, and I already said I want to play the devil's advocate here. Sometime last year, I think on the 6th of, I've forgotten the date, but sometime last year, when Honorable Dr. Ojiang brought a motion on herdsmen killing, Honorable Shagari, when he was responding to that motion, contributing, said something. He said he's a Fulani man, he has cattle, he has run those cattle, and that he knows that those herdsmen, those killer herdsmen, are not Nigerians. That by their intonation, by their way of dressing, you will know that they are not Nigerians. When Governor El-Rufai was speaking on television the other day, last year, he said the same thing, that he's a Fulani man and that he knows that most of these people who are killing are not Nigerians. The governor of Kano State only recently, last week, echoed the same thing. Again, last week, on Senator Abu Ibrahim, who is the Senate chairman on police affairs, went specific. He said these people, most of these people are even Libyans who have soldiers who have scattered as a result of the problems, the troubles that we have in Libya. So these are Fulani men speaking, that those who are killing us are not Nigerians. So when people wonder why we live with these people for some time and suddenly they have started to kill, we should take a look at that from that angle. Now, that should make the problem easier to resolve. If we have people coming from outside and killing Nigerians, it should be easy to tackle. However, that is not the case. Why? I've consistently said there is no political will on the part of the presidency. This presidency, there is no political will to tackle these people. Maybe because of tribal affinity, cultural affinity, but the question that I normally ask is, why do you prefer outsiders, non-Nigerians, to come here and kill people, maybe because of cultural affinity, over your countrymen? I say that with a lot of responsibility. But I don't see the same determination on the part of the president in tackling this issue the way he's tackling Boko Haram. Both are inherited problems. Of course, it's not because of President Buhari that the herdsmen have started to kill people. No, that would be unfair. It's a problem that has been inherited by this regime. The same way the Boko Haram was inherited. But we see a determination on the part of the president to tackle Boko Haram. Today we are celebrating that technically we have overcome them. Can we celebrate the same when we're talking about the herdsmen? I have consistently advocated that we disarm these people. You can't have a large number of people, killers, coming into Benue State and killing over 70 persons, and the security people will be unaware of it or not know what to do about it. I mean, security people are more competent than that. If they set their minds to doing their work, they have, in the past, proved that they are very competent, if the political will is there. The political win so far, I see not there as far as the issue of herdsmen concerned, is concerned. Now, I've taken a look at, let's not forget that we have two motions that have been consolidated, we are treating as one. The motion that is on page, that was on the other paper, I don't think we should begin to invite the service chiefs here. The speaker mentioned that sometime in June last year, we invited them over the same issue of insecurity. They came and briefed us, and we have had countless number of resolutions on the floor of this house. I think we should look beyond that. I'd rather go with those who are saying, maybe set up an ad hoc committee or whatever committee that you want to refer this matter to take a look. The best way we can approach this matter, we have countless number of resolutions that are pending, that have not been acted upon. Because if you bring them here, they will talk and tell us what they have been trying to do, not different from what they said last year in June when we called them here. By the way, the speaker told us that they called the leadership of the National Assembly yesterday or sometime back and you know, unveiled plans to try to tackle these things. So I don't think that is the way to go. The way to go is to tackle it from our own point of view. Just set up a committee here. Maybe that committee will liaise with the security chief, the other side, and let's find a way, because we don't like resolutions. We have had them countless number of times. Each time we have this kind of motion on the floor of the house. Okay? So we should actually look at it from the security point of view. Disarm these people. These people are not spirits. The other time, there was an attack in Buruku, that is my constituency. The governor went there, and these people will come the other side. Governor and his team will come this side, and they were interfacing. The same people who killed people the previous night. So we know them. It's not as if they are spirits. Until we do that, we'll continue to have motions and resolutions and motions and resolutions, and it will continue. Meaning that we have failed as a government. And the Constitution uses the word primary purpose of government, meaning that every other thing is secondary. If we can't get that right, it means we are getting every other thing wrong. That's my contribution, Mr. Speaker. Of motion number six, that seeks to invite all the security chiefs to the House, instead to set up another committee of the House to interface with the security chiefs and report back to the House within 4 weeks. That other committee would interface with also, I mean, with the security view, the security chiefs, with a view to also disarming all those with illegal arms. That will be the major brief of that committee. Mr. Speaker, my dear colleagues, I so move.